The Key2 is a tasty little slice of history, as it's the first BlackBerry phone to come rocking a dual lens camera. Of course, dual lens smartphone snap is as popular as right now, so it's no real surprise to see BlackBerry doubling up. But can the mighty Berry match or better its rivals when it comes to the smartphone optics? Well, I've been using it for a full week now, and here's my full Key2 camera review. Oh, and please don't forget to subscribe for more on the Key2 and all the latest and greatest mobile phones that are just hitting the UK. Now, first off, let's just quickly rattle off the boring spec stuff. The Key2 sports a 12 megapixel primary lens with an f1.8 aperture, and that's backed by a secondary 12 megapixel lens, again, this time with an f2.6 aperture. It uses dual phase detection autofocus, and there's no built-in optical image stabilization, just EIS. Boot up that camera app, one quick way is with a quick double tap of that power button, and you'll find you've got quite a lot of stuff to play around with. It can be a little bit daunting at first, especially because you've got all these various toggles. Over on the left-hand side, you've got a couple of essential bits, such as the HDR mode, which helps out with high contrast situations. You can activate the flash, change the aspect ratio, and dive into the settings menu. Over on the right-hand side, you've got this magic wand thingy, which is basically just a bunch of filters for anyone who still buggers about with those. And confusingly, there's also another camera icon, just like the one found on the shutter button. But this one actually pops up a menu of bonus camera modes. There's a small selection there, including, unsurprisingly, a portrait mode, which makes full use of that fresh dual lens setup. On top of that, you can jump into the video mode, scan some text, jump into panorama, and do a bit of slow motion video. Once you start snapping, that focus is pleasingly quick to act, locking onto your subject effectively as long as you don't try and get really up close and personal. When lighting is on your side, the chances are good that your photos will look rather pretty. Viewing back my photo album on a big display, I found that I got sharp results with plenty of detail packed in there. Colours were also reproduced rather accurately, so vivid scenes really shine when viewed back on a big screen. High contrast shots also generally come out rather well. You can shoot a building or a monument against a bright sunny sky, and generally the sky will actually come out with rather natural colours. However, I did see some examples of oversaturation when the lighting was particularly strong. And low light shots are unfortunately the Achilles heel of the Key2. When conditions get a bit dim, the results immediately turn quite fuzzy. Colours are rather flat and photos simply aren't very attractive at all. But there is good news if you take any, shall we say, more sensitive photos. If you lightly tap the fingerprint sensor instead of the shutter button, your photo will be stored away securely in the locker app and not shared to the likes of Google Photos. So your mum won't get a nasty shock when she logs onto your cloud account to check out some snaps of the grandkids and finds herself confronted with Mr. Salami and the Meatball Twins. As for that portrait mode, it seems to do a pretty decent job. Your subject's silhouette will appear nice and crisp, and the background has a nice blurry bokeh style effect to really help them to stand out. Swapping to video mode is unfortunately a wee bit awkward. You have to basically go into that camera modes menu and then tap the tiny little video icon in order to switch over. And confusingly, the shutter icon doesn't change at all in video mode. You might think that you maybe mishit the menu option, but no, it really will begin recording the movie once you tap it. Thankfully, the home movie quality on the whole is solid. The lens is once again fast acting and sucks up plenty of detail. Standard Full HD footage looks perfectly good, and audio quality is also more than respectable. You get a proper stereo effect when you're listening back with a pair of headphones, and distortion is always kept to a minimum, though occasionally it can be a little bit difficult to make out what anyone stood in front of the camera is actually saying unless they speak up a little bit. If you jack up the video quality to 60 frames per second, the result is nice and fluid, while 4K shooting offers a beautifully crisp finish, albeit with a typical 5-minute time limit. In fact, the only real issue beyond the obvious low light limitations is the rubbish image stabilization. Even at the basic Full HD 30fps setting, we'd recommend keeping as still as possible, or you're likely to sick up everywhere when you're watching your home movies back. And that, in a nutshell, is what we think of the BlackBerry Key2's camera after a full week of using. Don't forget to check out our in-depth BlackBerry Key2 review for our thoughts on the rest of this gorgeous little 2018 handset as well. Hit that subscribe button if you want to know more about the latest and greatest tech, and as always, love you, thanks, bye!